Chapter 1, Basic Organization of a Computer System. We are going to discuss about the basic organization of a computer system. In this diagram, there are 5 different units: input unit, output unit, storage unit, control unit, arithmetic logic unit. Input unit is one in which programs and data will be present. Output unit is one in which all the information will be stored. Storage unit can be classified into 2 different types: secondary storage and primary storage. In CPU, we have 2 units: control unit and arithmetic logic unit, which controls all the operations of a given system. There are 2 different lines. First one is data control and second one is flow control. Data control transmits the data from one end to the another end, and flow control transfers from one place to another place. Now we are going to discuss about all the 5 different types: input unit, central processing unit, control unit, arithmetic logic unit, registers and storage unit. Let's discuss about basic organization of a computer system. Generally, a computer is an electronic device which accepts the input, processes the data and produces the result. First topic is input unit. Input unit, the user interacts with the computer through input devices like keyboard, mouse, joystick. The data can be given with the help of an input unit. It accepts the data from the user, converts into a form which can be understood by the computer. This is called as input unit. The input may be zeros and ones. Now we are going to discuss about central processing unit. It controls, coordinates and supervises the operation of a computer. This CPU is called as a central processing unit, which is also called as brain of a computer. It consists of arithmetic logic unit, control unit, registers. Let's see what is meant by arithmetic logic unit. It consists of arithmetic logic unit that performs all the arithmetic logic operations on the input data. This arithmetic operations such as plus, minus, star and division, and logical operations may be and, or and not. Control unit. It controls overall operations of a computer. In control unit, all the operations can be controlled. Registers. It is a temporary storage of data or instructions, addresses and intermediate results can be stored. This registers is the place where temporary data will be stored. Next, we can discuss about storage unit. There are 2 types of memory associated with storage unit. First one is primary memory. Primary memory is one which is present inside the system, is called primary memory. It is called as main memory, which consists of RAM and ROM. First, let's see what is meant by RAM. RAM stands for random access memory, where the data is permanent. ROM is nothing but read only memory, where the data is not permanent. It can be called as non-volatile. It stores the data, instructions, intermediate results and the output temporarily. Based upon that, the processing can be done. Now we shall discuss about second type of memory called as secondary memory. The other name of secondary memory is external memory. Why it is called as external memory? Reason: it is present outside the system, so it is called as external memory. Here In external memory, it stores the data permanently in the programs as output. The output unit provides and processes the data and generates the result on the screen. Example, monitor in which the screen or output can be displayed on the corresponding screen.